In the last video, we saw how to implement a system for our units to be able to follow other units by using the state machine. And in this video, we are going to give our unit stats like HP and defense and the ability to attack their enemies. This is the scene we are going to be working with. We have three enemies that are going to be our little punching bags. And the enemies now have a particle system that's going to help us see when they are being hit by our units. Also, our units have a much better and much more organized root script. By using the header attribute in our variables, we can really improve the way our script is shown in the inspector, and they also have a new script called basic attack that is the one that will allow our units to attack their enemies when they enter their combat state. This is our improved root script. As you can see, there is the same states as before for our state machine. This is how you implement the header attribute so that the word state is shown before the state variables in the inspector in the scene. So to give our units stats, the only thing we have to do is declare the new variables. Here we can see the stats our units are going to have. We have HP for hit points, defense, attack, attack variation that is going to be used to give the attack a little bit of randomness, so it's not always 10, 10, 10, 10 in the damage they give to the enemies, but it's going to be a number between 10 minus 2 and 10 plus 2. We are going to see that when we are working with the basic attack script. So the other two stats we are going to give our units is R, attack speed, which is how fast they can attack, and R reach, to see how close they need to be to their enemies to actually hit them. Something else about our new root script is that it no longer has the list for the enemies, because that is going to be handled by the basic attack script. And also we have a reference for the particle system that is going to be our visual cue for when units get hit. There is also a new line of code in the initialization of our root script. That is to get the particle system component out of one of the children of our unit. Finally, we have the change state function that allows us to change the state of the unit, and a new take damage function that allows us to update the HP of our units when they take damage. The damage argument of this function is the raw amount of damage that something is trying to deal to the unit. And the first thing that happens when this function executes is that it emits some particles from the damaged particle we now have. The next thing that we need to do is subtract the unit's defense from the raw amount of damage that something is trying to deal to the unit. And we do this with a ternary operator that allows us to check first if the damage minus the defense of the unit is less or equal than zero, then we are going to get one damage. This is the minimum damage a unit can get. It's always going to be one. Now that we have calculated the real damage, have to modify the HP of the unit. We also do this with a ternary operator that lets us evaluate if the HP minus the real damage that we are getting is less or equal than zero, then we are going to set the HP of the unit to zero. If this condition evaluates to false, then we are going to set in the HP current HP minus the real damage that we are getting. Finally, if our unit's HP is less or equal to zero, Then we destroy that unit by destroying the game object of the unit. Something else we have to talk about is the detection script, because it has been simplified. Before, this script used to handle the detection of enemies, but now this script only takes care of detecting any kind of unit that enters the detection zone, and adds those units to the detection list that we have on the root script, this detection list. Because the detection of enemies, or the script that checks if there are enemies in our detection list, is going to be our basic attack script. These are the variables of our attack script. First, of course, we have the root of the unit, the root script of the unit, and we also have a reference to the root script of our target. Then we have a list where we are going to see all the enemies we have in range or in our detection zone. And then we have a boolean that is going to let us know if we are ready to attack. That's going to be activated based on the attack speed of the unit. We have a reference to the navigation mesh agent component of the unit, and these two variables over here are just for rotation, so that the unit can always be looking at its target. On the initialization of this script, we get our root component, our navigation mesh agent component, and we invoke the function named readyAction in 2.5 seconds. 2.5 seconds is going to be the attack speed of the unit, as we can see here. This readyAction function is down here, and all it does is to set the attack ready boolean to true. That's the only thing this function does. Now let's see what's going to happen step by step in the update function of our attack script. The first thing we have to do is look for enemies in the detected objects, or the detected list. So the first step to do so is to clear the list of enemies, to like renew it. Then we do a for each loop on the detected list, which has all the detected units around our unit, and we say that if the detected object is not null, so there is in fact a detected object, we check if the tag of that object is orc. Remember, all our enemies have the orc tag on them, and if this evaluates to true, we add that object to our enemy list. The second thing we have to do is evaluate if there are in fact any enemies. We do so with this conditional. If the enemy list.count is greater than 0, then there are enemies. Then we're going to target the nearest enemy to the unit. And we do that doing this process right here. The first thing we have to do is to assign any enemy in our enemy list as our first enemy for comparison. That's what this line of code does. Then we run a for each loop with all the enemies on the enemy lists. Then we get the distance from the unit to the first enemy, or the enemy we already have as our target. You see? The distance between the unit and the one that is already targeted, and the distance between the unit and the first enemy of the enemy list. Then we compare those distances and select the one that is closer to the unit. At the end of this loop, we are going to have the nearest enemy set in our target root variable. Now, the third step we have to do is to check if our unit is not in the moving state. Remember that the moving state takes priority over the combat state in our state machine. So if the unit is not moving, then we change the state of our unit to the combat state. The next step is to chase our target if we are not close enough. We check the distance between the unit and our target, and if it is greater than the reach of our unit, then we have to use our nav mesh agent component to move closer to our target until we can reach our target. Now, when we are close enough to the target, we need to stop moving, but we need to keep looking at our targets. And this involves a rotation. Rotations are never easy to make, but I'm going to show you this little method of rotations using the smooth damp angle function. Okay, the first argument of the smooth damp angle function is going to be the rotation in Y of our unit. The rotation in the Y axis of our unit. Then we need to set the target rotation we want to look at, which is the Y Euler angle of the rotation we are trying to look at. Then we need to add a float by reference. I don't know what this does, it's just one of the arguments of the smooth damp functions. And then we need to set a speed at which to rotate. So we have the rotate speed when attacking variable multiplied by the time of this frame, which is time dot delta time. Finally, we get the Euler angles of our unit, and in the Y Euler angle of our unit, we set the variation we just calculated. As you know, in the transform component of the unit, the rotation is actually a quaternion, but what we see here in the transform of the inspector are the Euler angles of the transform, not the actual rotation. But anyways, that's just rotation stuff. Let's move on with the basic attack script. The last thing we have to check before attacking is if the unit is ready to attack. So, if the attack ready boolean is true, we need to reset it back to false and invoke the ready action function in 2.5 seconds, which is the attack speed of our unit. So, 2.5 seconds after the unit has attacked, we are going to be ready to attack again. Finally, we have to calculate the damage we are going to deal to our target. To add a little bit of randomness to the damage we deal in each hit, we are going to use our attack variation stat, which in this case is 2, and our base attack is 10. So with this calculation right here, our damage is going to be a random number between 8 and 12. So it is between, so it takes the base damage and it adds to it a number between minus 2 and plus 2, which is what this random dot range right here is doing. Finally, we take our target root script and use the take damage function with the damage we just calculated. That's everything we have to do to actually attack our target. Now, one last thing, we have to return to to our idle state if there are no targets. So remember this conditional right here where we checked if there was at least one enemy in our enemy list. Well, if there is no enemy, we land right here in this conditional. So if there are no enemies and our current state is combat state, we go ahead and reset the state of the unit to the idle state. And that's it. That's the whole basic attack script. And that's it. That's everything you have to do to give your unit some stats and the ability to attack its enemies. On the next video, we are going to implement floating HP bars for each unit and also floating text to display how much damage we deal to our enemies in every hit. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below, and thank you so much for watching this video.